This is Utah, the King Cobra. This is the largest venomous snake in the entire world. We absolutely love him. He's a very switched on snake. You gotta be careful when working with Utah. These ones were one of Dad's favorites too.
Cobras are great. I'm flared up, I'm a cobra, and if you come too close, I'm gonna have to strike. So they give you the warning.
Our team has noticed a few behavioural differences in Utah. He's been acting a little bit off. He hasn't been shedding his skin like he should be. And there's a few things that indicate that it could be kidney problems. The King Cobra in the wild is unfortunately an endangered species, and that's mainly due to habitat loss. It's really important that we have animals like Utah at Australia Zoo because he is contributing to a breeding program and he's also educating the public about their conservation issues. So Nick, the head of reptiles, he's actually going to be injecting a saline solution into the frozen rats that we feed Utah. We're hoping that this is actually going to get his blood levels back to normal.
When we first noticed the issue with Utah, the initial blood results came back with a very high uric acid level. Generally speaking, it's indicative of something going on with his kidney function.
We'd inject as much saline as we possibly can into his food items to try and minimise the levels of uric acid that we received in his previous blood results. So essentially, all we're trying to do is hydrate the animal as best as we possibly can. All right, now the fun bit.
I love Utah because he's really curious, really intelligent, always looking around, soaking everything up. However, never be caught off guard. You have to be ready, you have to be really focused on him and know that he is a highly venomous snake.
Hey, buddy. Good boy, mate.
Cobras can induce one of the largest venom yields of any species of snake on the planet, upwards of 500 milligrams.
All right, we'll just try and bring him over this way a little bit.
A cobra bite is considered a fatal bite for a human.
Oh, how awesome is that?
They have incredibly acute vision and they seem to be a problem-solving snake. So you can see that he starts to manipulate the animal and then he will start to use his fangs at the top as an anchor point and he starts walking his jaws over the top of the animal. He's just such a beautiful animal. It'd be a crying shame to see him deteriorate in any way. The only real way to see if this treatment has worked is to do some blood tests. But the biggest problem with that is actually getting the blood from a 3.5 metre cobra.
Wes and I have to go in and catch Utah.
I don't know what he's gonna do, so you're gonna have to keep a little bit of distance because he might just swing around and the first thing he'll grab is probably you.
This is very dangerous. Wes is by far the most competent and experienced snake handler. He worked directly with Dad, so there's no one better to do this procedure with.
All right, what are we up to? Mate, got these fierce snakes, gonna give him a bit of tucker.
Yeah?
What do you reckon?
Wes has gotta try and stir him up and get them excited about food. Here we go, here we go. That's it, hit.
When you work in a zoo that has so many highly dangerous reptiles and snakes, you gotta learn the ropes. Steve taught me everything I know, so Robert's now in the process of learning, and so the King Cobra is one of the pinnacles.
Whew. Oh, here we go.
All right.
Oh, wow.
Look at this guy.
This is one of the most venomous snakes in the world. Just looking at your eye, like they just look straight into your eyes, like, what are you doing? Very, very smart snake, which makes them even more dangerous. You know, they know what's going on.
The reason for the bloods is to determine whether Utah's renal function is where we need it to be. We need to know that he's well hydrated, that his uric acid levels are sitting normally. The dangers are that he can rapidly deteriorate within a period of 12 to 24 months.
Wes is going to take him out of his enclosure, set him on the ground, and this tube will be laying just on the floor. And then he'll actually snake right into the tube, and then we'll pick him up, put him on the table, and we'll be able to take bloods. shaken.
Yeah.
Oh, he's on it.
How intelligent.
Look at that. As soon as he saw that movement, he was right on it. Instead of trying to pin that head down, that's not great for the snake. By funneling him into that little tube and keeping him in there, we'll be able to get in and do all of our tests. However, as soon as you lay a hand on the snake, that's when they're really on high alert. A snake of that size, their strike range is absolutely huge.
You don't know what the snake's gonna do.
Go around this way. Good boy, it's okay.
You know, he's strong, he's fast, he's on the board. I've got to be ready to move, you know? You got to kind of be a half a second in front of them.
Go around this way.
I mean, I'm within the strike range. You know, he knows. He doesn't want to go in that tube. They all give off body language. From the subtleties of the way they move their head to the way they look at you. And that's the art form of dealing with big venomous snakes.
Okay. Okay, you can grab a bit of it, Robert.
Yep.
Come in, guys.
Okay. He's a big boy.
Okay, let's get him over there.
That was awesome. I'm just speechless. That was so cool. Wes did an amazing job.
My heart's going. Hey, Sam.
Well done. Very good.
How was that?
That was awesome.
We're hoping that this animal's gonna realize that we're trying to help it, that we mean it no harm, and Dr. Sam will be able to get in and take those bloods.
The reason that we use the tail vein to collect blood, it's the most accessible vein, so it's quite near the surface. Snakes' scales are quite thick and tough, so we need to be very careful to gently insert the needle to get to the vein.
There we go.
Nice work,
Sam. Oh, that's awesome, well done.
So now, Robert, if you're able to put your thumb on, so yep. Quite a lot of pressure on there.
Yep.
So we just need to get this blood into the anticoagulant as soon as possible.
Yep.
The thing we're most interested in with him, of course, is the uric acid, which will give us a really good indication of his kidney function.
You're done with him now?
Yep, definitely.
Yep, my goodness. The quicker the process is, the less stress there is on the snake.
Can you climb in there for me?
Yep.
And get him in? And then just gently take him back up the corner a bit more, that way, right along the window.
Yep.
And then jump out.
Yep. Right here.
Yep, perfect.
Now.
Yep, here out.
Yep, I'm out.
Okay, you ready? I'm gonna release him. Okay, here we go.
I'm still kind of shaking a little bit, but yeah, it was just, it's so exciting being there with this animal. Oh, it was wild.
Oh.
Robert was on the ball.
Good job, Utah.
Oh, look at him.
Before, when he was little, it was like, watch out, Robert. He's there as a backup now.
Oh, that was awesome.
We're both sweating.
Yeah.
Oh. He's an absolute asset. I'm really, really enjoying working with him.
Fingers crossed, all the tests are going to be positive and Utah's going to be fine.
Reptiles are so cryptic and sometimes we don't really know what's going on until they're really sick. At his first blood sample, we were very concerned about his kidney function. All right, so let's have a look. They've just come through now, which is very exciting. So we'll have a look at the results. Yes, perfectly normal, which is great. So the uric acid has dropped to about 1/5 of what it was originally. So a massive drop and fantastic to see that back into normal range. We absolutely try our hardest to do what we can and this is a fantastic outcome.
All right, let's see how he's going. Hello, Utah.
Hey, mate.
Oh, he's looking really, really good. Utah's test results are great. He's happy, he's healthy, he's definitely gonna be recovering from now on.
So I'm really, really happy with this.
Hello.
He's so vitally important for us at Australia Zoo, but also for King Cobra conservation worldwide.
He's back to his old self. Good on you, Utah.
Perfect.